From the outside, it's impossible to tell that there's anything wrong with the school. Inside, it's a different story. But despite the damage you're about to see, the principal says the students will be back in class tomorrow.
So it is a little overwhelming now that I'm looking at it, but
it is what it is.
What it is a big mess, caused when this part of a radiant heating system in Susan Gamache's classroom let go.
It's a coupling that joins a copper pipe with a PEX pipe, and it just appeared to have given way.
The system was just installed in October. Why the coupling let go, no one knows, but eight classrooms suffered severe water damage.
A big part of teaching is showing student models, student work, so all of that's gone.
Along with most of the materials that Gamache bought with her own money over 18 years of teaching. Next door, Ron Jocks was surveying the damage done to what was left of his classroom. As bad as the physical damage is, Jocks says the educational impact may be worse.
There's going to be moments where I'm not going to be able to do things that I want to do, and that's going to be tough.
The principal says they'll temporarily replace the lost classrooms by making other places in the school do double duty.
We'll be making use of spaces such as our computer lab. Our media center will set up as a classroom space as opposed to a library. And there are other places where we're going to juggle the schedule.
But as bad as things look now, the estimate is that all the repairs will be done and the students back in their regular classrooms in a couple of weeks. And school district officials are confident there won't be any long-lasting effects.
We've had moisture readings and tests, and there's no fear of mold at this time.
As far as the cost of all this, well, there's no damage estimate yet, but school district officials say the company that installed the heating system will be held responsible. As for the lost days, the principal says right now they'll be treated as snow days to be made up in June. However, it's possible that the superintendent of schools here in Concord could apply for a waiver so that the students at this middle school get out on time with the rest of the district. Reporting live in Concord, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.